As we explore the themes in Quantum Body, my next book with Jack Tuzinski and Brian Fertig. Jack is a quantum biologist and an expert in quantum mechanics and physics. Brian is a neuroendocrinologist like myself. So in this new book, you will hear the term creative intelligence quite a bit. But before that, let's address a deeper question, which is the current discussion in neuroscience and consciousness studies on what are called conscious agents. So conscious agent refers to a system that is capable of experiencing the world and acting on it in a purposeful way. This implies that the system must be able to perceive its environment and generate internal representations of the environment. It must be able to make decisions about how to act based on those internal representations. And it must be able to execute actions in the world to achieve its goals. Conscious agents are typically thought to be self-aware, meaning that they are aware of their own existence and their own mental states. So there is some overlap here between what we call conscious agents and what spiritual traditions might call the soul. Here are some examples of conscious agents: humans, other animals such as chimpanzees and dogs, but actually I would say even go further, all animals and even plants. And today, artificial intelligence systems that are capable of learning and acting on their own, although they do not have subjective awareness. They do not have subjective awareness. In that they don't feel hunger, etc., etc. Hunger, sexual urges, fear of death, etc. But let's look at human conscious agents and see if we can explore their reality as non-local agents beyond space-time. Some studies have shown that humans can access information that is not physically present in their environments, such as precognitive dreams, remote viewing experiments, etc. Additionally, some studies have shown that human conscious agents can affect the physical world in ways that cannot be explained by conventional physics, such as psychokinesis experiments. One hypothesis that attempts to explain these phenomena is that human consciousness is non-local and exists beyond space and time. This hypothesis is supported by some findings in quantum mechanics, which suggest that information can be transmitted instantaneously between entangled particles. If consciousness is non-local, it would mean that it is not bound by the constraints of space and time, and therefore could access information and affect the physical world in ways that current science does not understand. Here are some specific examples of research that supports the hypothesis of non-local consciousness. Precognitive dreams. A study published in the journal Dreaming in 2010 found that people who had precognitive dreams were more likely to correctly predict future events than people who did not have precognitive dreams. Remote viewing experiments. A study published in the Journal of Parapsychology in 2012 found that people who were trained in remote viewing were able to accurately describe distant locations and events at a rate that was significantly higher than by chance. That most people call these spiritual experiences, dormant non-local abilities, precognition, remote viewing, memories of other lifetimes, and as I mentioned, precognition. Psychokinesis, a study published in the journal Nature in 2013, found that people were able to influence the outcome of random events, computer-generated random events using their minds. So all these studies do suggest that we, as fundamental beings or reality, are conscious agents along with other sentient beings. When we talk about artificial intelligence, just think of artificial intelligence as extended human intelligence. Now let's come to the term creative intelligence. This is the ability to generate original and innovative ideas, solutions, and even products and services. It's been happening ever since we discovered the wheel, fire, conveyor belts, and all the automation and the automobile and aviation industries and more, but now through algorithms in artificial intelligence systems. So I would say that artificial intelligence is an extension of human intelligence. Artificial intelligence is augmented human intelligence. Now, coming back to creative intelligence, here are some examples of creative intelligence in nature. So birds have evolved a wide variety of creative solutions to the challenges of survival and reproduction. For example, some birds build elaborate nests to protect their eggs and chicks. Others use camouflage to hide from predators, and still others have developed complex songs and dances to attract mates. How about bees? Bees are known for their intricate communication dances, which they use to direct other bees to food sources. They have also evolved a sophisticated system for building and defending their hives. What about plants? Plants have developed a wide range of creative adaptations to different environments. For example, some plants have evolved deep roots to reach water in dry areas. Others have developed their thick leaves to protect themselves from the sun. And still others have evolved poisonous sap to deter predators. These are just a few of the examples of creative intelligence. So creative intelligence can be applied to nature in many, many ways that I've not even mentioned. And the future possibilities of creative intelligence are the developing of renewable energy resources. Scientists are using creative intelligence to develop new and more efficient ways to generate renewable energy from sources such as the sun, wind, and water. And also, there are many examples of creative intelligence and natural resources. Creative intelligence is also being used to develop new ways to conserve natural resources such as water and energy. So scientists and engineers are developing new water-efficient irrigation systems and energy. Creative intelligence can be used to restore damaged ecosystems such as forests and wetlands. This can help to promote biodiversity, protect water quality, and mitigate the effects of climate change. So, what is the source of all this creative intelligence? It can only be non-local consciousness, a borderless, immeasurable, infinite, irreducible, fundamental reality, which is without cause. And it is consciousness or awareness without borders. Okay. It is the boundless which gives rise to the appearance of boundaries. And it is fundamental reality. It is Atman, it is Brahman, and ultimately it is you. You are creative intelligence. You are a conscious agent in an ecosystem of conscious agents, which we call nature, and tapping into it by going to the source of all experience, not identifying with the contents of experience, which are ephemeral, fleeting, and transitory and ungraspable as sensations, images, feelings, thoughts, and sense perceptions, not identifying with them, but identifying with the source of all contents of experience. The source of all contents of experience modifies itself into mind, intellect, ego, the energetic body, the physical body entangled with the physical world as a unified process. And meditation and stilling the mind is the best way to access the infinite potential of creative intelligence as the human conscious agent. Let me know your thoughts.